And welcome to St. Zachary Parish. We give thanks to God that we are worshiping together today. Today in our liturgy, we celebrate our Lord Jesus Christ, King of the universe. Our presider today is our pastor, Father Peter Rupsha, and our deacon is Roland Merced. Please stand.
Lord Jesus, we follow you, for you are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, we believe in you, for you are the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, we receive you, for you are the life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
sinners. Grant we pray that the whole creation set free from slavery may render your majesty service and proclaim your praise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the ancient one and was presented before him, the one like a son of man received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the book of Revelation. Jesus Christ is the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, and ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by his blood, who has made us into a kingdom, priests for his God and Father, to him be glory and power forever and ever. Amen. Behold, he is coming amid the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. All the peoples of the earth will lament him. Yes, amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, the one who is, and who was, and who is to come, the Almighty. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Pilate said to Jesus, "Are you the King of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you say this on your own, or have others told you about me?" Pilate answered, "I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom does not belong to this world. If my kingdom did belong to this world, my attendants would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not here." So Pilate said to him, "Then you are a king." Jesus answered, "You say I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I prepared a homily for this feast, the Christ, the King of the Universe, a couple of days ago. But something happened today, and I completely changed my homily. And I would like to talk about what changed my mind. Like every day, I am waking up around 4 and 5 a.m. I'm walking dog. Then I'm doing something to drink for myself, and then I'm going to gym to do my morning cardio. So I did it today. And in the headway of my cardio, someone just called me. So I had a conversation with a person, and while having that conversation, the window by me just broke, and I said to the person that I was talking, "So strange, I never saw something like that the window broke that way." But I don't really pay attention to that window. So I finished my gym, I came here, I took shower, I said the 9 o'clock mass, and then I start hearing the confession. During the confession, I saw a call from Des Plaines Police Department. So I answered the call, and they asked me about the accident at the gym. They asked me if I noticed something outside, maybe some person. I said I didn't, because it was dark, and I had a conversation with someone, so I didn't really pay attention to the things around me. So they said that they're gonna put me on hold, and they're gonna get back to me in a couple of minutes. So they did, and they said, "You know what happened? What we found? That someone shot, and that window was really close to me. So if I wanted to extend my hand, I would touch the window." And the policeman said to me, "Sir, this day is your lucky day." So this story reminds me about today's feast, because Christ is King of the past, present, and future. However, we are not. We cannot change the past. We don't know the future. The only thing that we have is here and now. But most of
the time, we pay attention to the past, to our mistakes, to our conflicts, or we pay the attention about the future, the worries that we have, what future is gonna bring. However, the most important thing is here and now, because we have this moment, and God is giving us this moment to build His kingdom here on earth. So brothers and sisters, let us use wisely the time that we have left, not for the past, not for the future, but for the present, using the time to build the kingdom of justice, love, and peace around us.
And now, brothers and sisters, let us profess together our faith. I believe in one God.
Let the response be, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church and our parish community, that we may be faithful witnesses to the love and mercy of our Heavenly Father, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the nations and peoples of the world, that they may serve one another in the justice and peace of God's reign, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who live under repressive regimes and all who are oppressed by unjust authorities, that they may be sustained during their time of trials, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those seeking the source of all goodness, that they may find the face of Christ the King reflected in the witness of our faith community, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all travelers, especially those traveling for Thanksgiving, that they travel safely and enjoy peace filled gatherings, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, especially Grace Berry, for their doctors and nurses, that they may know God's healing love and compassionate spirit, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died in Christ, that they may live in the kingdom of His truth for all eternity, especially Anne De Luca, Francis Paparotti, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions being offered at this Mass, for for Dennis and Timothy Gable, Christine Perchon, Len Risabecki, Mary Signorini, and Shirley Wise, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, hear these prayers we offer today and answer them according to your will, for we make them to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
There is a second collection today, and it is for the Catholic Campaign for Human Development. Thank you for your generosity.
Almighty and eternal. eternal God, for you anointed your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the oil of gladness. As eternal priest, the King of all creation, so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption and making all created things subject to his rule, he might present to your majesty an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so with angels and archangels, with the thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Forever and ever.
that by the help of your mercy may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as you await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of your
Lord Jesus Christ, who sent your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Love is of the Lord with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share each other the sign of peace.
Lord.
Amen.
The announcements for today are as follows. Our holiday bazaar is back. Please join us next Saturday, November 27th, between 9 a.m. and 4 p.m. in the school. See the bulletin for more information. The Ministry Center Chapel will be closed Wednesday, November 24th through Sunday, November 28th. Have a blessed and happy Thanksgiving. St. Zachary Queen of Heart has arrived. Tickets will go on sale this weekend. The first drawing will be held on Tuesday, November 23rd. See the bulletin for more information. All Eucharistic ministers and lectors, please see the sign-up book on the counter in the gathering area for holiday masses, and also anyone who would like to sign up to light the Advent candle at our mass time. See the book for more details. St. Zachary will be holding a drive at the end of November to help victims of domestic violence. The donations that the program is in need of will be on the yellow flyer placed in the gathering area. This drive is in support of the WINGS program. There will be a box placed in the gathering area to drop off donations. See the yellow flyer for the donations that are needed. Thank you for your support. St. Vincent de Paul is reaching out to help the less fortunate during the holidays. If you would be able to purchase $25 and/or $50 gift certificates to help our neighbors for the holidays. Votive candles in memory of our loved ones are being sold in the Ministry Center through the month of November. See the bulletin for hours of purchase. The Garden Club is collecting donations for a new riding lawn mower. Please see the display in the gathering area for more information, and we thank you.
Brothers and sisters, as we are approaching the beautiful day of Thanksgiving, let us be grateful to God for all the blessings that we have received from Him, because they are making us happy, and also for all challenges, because the challenges make us grow. Someone said that life is like piano, where the white keys represents the happy moments of our life, and the black keys represent the challenges and obstacles. But when you play the piano, the black keys make music too. One more thing. Next time your doctor is gonna say to you that the exercise is good for you, say to him, I don't think so, doctor. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Our Master Sunday, let us go in peace, love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.